secondly, we have the speakers every week. I mean, a lot of you we recognize, you've been here in the past year, you've spoken to us, and that inspires us. I've been amazed at the amount of local charities and things that people are doing. It's incredible, both locally and internationally. We've got Brian Murray this year. He does this water filtration system. We just turned on water in Nigeria in the last couple of days for 10,000 people. First time the village ever had clean water. That's from this club. We did that. We got donations from... big projects, but mostly small projects, and it's really the heart of people. I mean, the money we give is not going to totally change your lives, any of you, some of you are quite big organizations, but the heart that people have, that they bring, and you know, we know you're committed, and that inspires all of us every week. So you're our extension doing the work that we're doing. We can't do it all. We do some service projects, but we see you as an extension of us, helping us fulfill our mission to try and do good in the world, and we appreciate that. So we're going to get a snippet of each of you of what you do. As we set aside, we can be reasonably brief. We have a cheat sheet up here in case you forget what I told you outside. So feel free to do the trip notes. But yeah, just a quick introduction, about a minute to 2 minutes, and give us a helps appreciate what all of us are doing. Let's all celebrate it together. It's incredible work that everybody is doing. It's very touching. So Cindy is going to actually call out the orders in alphabetical order. So then. No first or last or more important, so equal importance.
Just briefly,
okay. All right, thanks. Well, good morning, everybody. Oh, my name, my organization, I got my notes here. So my name is Brian Horry. I've actually come to the Rotary Club now a few times over the years. We have a company called Pristina Capital Partners, and we manufacture water filtration equipment that doesn't require electricity. We also have a not-for-profit called Water for the Global Community, which the Rotary has actually supported in the past for us when we were in Indonesia. The scope of our equipment, our water filtration equipment, we run from Indonesia, Kenya, Ghana, Nigeria, which we'll talk about in a second, Haiti, Panama. So we cover about 20,000 people with our water filtration equipment now. Water for the Global Community's main mission is to provide clean water. And we teamed up with Rotary International, with Paul and Peter's help, and it was about a $30,000 project, all in? $35,000 project, all in, to create this water system in Nigeria, in a small little village that never had water before. So it was a very, you know, it was a good, happy ending. It started by my meeting Father Felix, who was a visiting, priest from Nigeria, Catholic priest. I belong to St. Eve's, and he was at a visiting land 2 summers ago, and we started talking about the need for water in Nigeria and Africa. There's a big, big need. It's we actually have demand right now for 2 units in Ethiopia, 3 in Ghana, 1 in Kenya, so it's an ongoing need. And Father Felix explained to him his need. We met with the guys from the Rotary Club, and it wasn't easy, but Paul did a great job in getting us through Rotary International. We got the project done, and now the people there are very happy with clean water. And that's enough, right? Okay.
Our first recipient is Bergen Volunteer Medical Initiative, Dr. Ken Herman, Amanda Missy, and Dr. Sam Castle.
Hi, everybody. I'm Amanda Missy. I'm the CEO of Bergen Volunteer Medical Initiative. We are a healthcare center located in Hackensack, and we provide free primary care to low-income working Bergen County residents who don't have insurance. We're expecting that we may have way more than the 1,000 patients that we have right now pretty soon. Who knows what's gonna happen with healthcare. The great news is we just moved into the Lynn Diamond Healthcare Center. It's a new 5,000 square foot facility in Hackensack. We raised a bunch of money to do it, so we're debt-free and we are moving forward. So what we're looking for right now, we're looking for patients. Got lots of space. I have these cool little cards. I've got them in English, Spanish, Korean, Polish, and Chinese, and they are meant to be given to people who might need healthcare. So I would love to have you come back there and get some for me. Hand them out at your favorite restaurant, your nail salon, to your landscaper, your nanny, whoever. We're also looking for volunteers, so if you know any doctors, nurses, nurse practitioners, social workers, dietitians, anybody clinical that might want to volunteer some time, it's a great place to volunteer. Send them my way. Thank you so much for this donation. You said that it's not going to change anybody's life because some of us are big organizations. trust me, that will change somebody's life. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next recipient is Eastern Christian Children's Retreat, Kimberly Salas.
Hi, I'm Kimberly Salas with Eastern Christian Children's Retreat. We provide residential services for people with intellectual and developmental disabilities. The money will be used to buy some new equipment. Thank you.
Next, have Family Support Organization of Bergen County. Roe Libretto is here to accept.
Morning, it's great to be back. I've been here before. We appreciate the support that you give to the Family Support Organization. We're a 501c3 not-for-profit that provides support, education, and advocacy to families who have children with emotional, behavioral, developmental, or substance abuse issues. And what's nice about it, we focus on the family when you have a child who needs some assistance. And I should note that Amy Garlick, the board president of the FSOBC, is an active member of this Rotary, and that's how we got connected. So thank you very much.
We have Friends of the Midland Park Library, and I have Catherine DeLeo and Vivian Madisick.
Hi, I'm Catherine DeLeo, the director of the Midland Park Library. This is my first time here. I'm happy to be here. The library really, the main goal is to provide excellent services, programs, and the best materials we can get for the community. And this donation would help support that. Thank you.
And we have Friends of the White Wolf Library, and we have accepting on behalf of Friends Virginia Nehas.
I'd like to thank the Rotary for a wonderful breakfast, and I'm so happy to be here and accept this donation for the Wyckoff Library. I use the library all the time, and I know it's more than just books. So thank you so much.
Habitat for Humanity with Patterson. We have Barbara Dunn here accepting.
I'm the executive director of Patterson Habitat for Humanity. We've been building homes in the city of Patterson for over 31 years and helped about 300 families become homeowners. Our work brings self-reliance and independence to families, and at the same time, we're rebuilding communities. We're currently focused in the 4th and the 1st wards. And in addition to our housing in Patterson, we tithe on our donations, and so we will. We built almost 500 houses overseas. Our sister affiliate is in Kenya, where we're sending a team in November to build. And I see that you've supported things there. So go to our website. We're currently recruiting for a trip down to New Orleans in February, and love to have you come out and build with us sometime. The donation will be used for a front door and a front door light on a house on Hamilton Avenue in Patterson. And so if you drive through that street, that community, I hope that you'll think of the families that will be able to open and close their own house because of your generosity. Thank you.
Next, we have Healing Waters Veterans Fly Fishing, and we have Rich Melizia accepting on behalf of Healing Waters.
Good morning. I'm Rich Melizia. I'm a member of East Jersey Chapter of Travel Unlimited. We partnered with Project Healing Waters Fly Fishing through our Veterans Outreach Program, and we're working with a newly formed unit in the Wyckoff Midland Park area that focuses on outpatient disabled veterans. All of our programs are geared to the disabled vets. All of the funding for all of the activities are financed through our local chapter or through our national organization. There's never any out-of-pocket costs for any of the things that we do. Why fly fishing? Somewhere along the line down at Walter Reed, one of the doctors who was also a fly fisher realized that the movements associated with fly casting help develop both fine and gross motor skills for disabled vets. Additionally, activities such as fly rod building and fly tying work on concentration, focus, creativity, also fine motor skills. It's very rewarding when we sit at one of our meetings and see a disabled vet who might have an issue with tremors and watch how those tremors settle down as they begin. We do outings. One of the issues that we have, because we have a fairly large group of 15 to 20 individuals, is to find locations that will accommodate us. It often takes us away from publicly accessible property. So many of our activities are at places like recently, we went up to Skytop Lodge for a day. We have transportation costs, oftentimes ride fees or entrance fees, all of which the organization absorbs for the disabled vets. Those of us that are volunteers recognize that we pay our own way. We have no administrative costs at the local unit level, and we're all happy to participate and reach into our pockets, and we thank you for reaching into your pockets for all of us. Thank you.
Midland Park Love Fund and Midland Park Players Organization, and we have Lori Camp accepting on their behalf.
Good morning. I'd like to say thank you on behalf of both organizations. Midland Park Children's Love Fund provides financial support for families who have hit a bump in the road, I'll call it, whether it's a financial difficulty which came about because of illness or single parenthood or job loss. And we typically support them with grocery gift cards. And Park Players is a summer theater group. I believe Zoe even did it when she was younger. Which has been going on in Midland Park for probably 25 years minimum. And it's a rec program for kids in Midland Park who are looking for something to do besides your typical rec program, like, you know, with the ball and all that. And your donation is a great help to us because we try to keep the cost down because it is a rec program, and a lot of our campers eventually become employees, and some of them don't ever leave because they go on to actually, you know, I just coordinate the program. Our young people go on to direct, and they're the musical directors, the choreographers. And so it's a great, I don't know, I love the program because you start out as a camper there and you eventually become, you know, you take ownership of it. So thank you for letting us continue to do that.
Yeah, Midland Park Volunteer Ambulance Corps, and accepting is Alan Corman and First Lieutenant Jeff Allen.
And Laura Borges.
And Laura.
Hi, she said my name is Alan Corman. I am the president of the Midland Park Ambulance Corps. We just celebrated our 75th anniversary this year. We are now and always have been a completely autonomous organization. We are not borough owned or borough run. We raise all our funds through donations, and so this is very much appreciated that we can continue carrying on our service. Thank you.
Midland Park Volunteer Fire Department.
My name is Jay Green, the Assistant Chief of Midland Park Fire Department. We provide fire and rescue service on a volunteer basis at a borough, residents, businesses. If anybody's ever looking to volunteer, we 18 or older, we're always looking for members. And the check we were receiving, we were grateful for, and we'll go towards purse of equipment to keep our services going. Thank you.
Jeffrey, Oasis, a haven for women and children.
Hi, I'm Jen Brady, Oasis, the Haven for Women and Children in Patterson. Our mission is to help impoverished women and children rise out of poverty, and the Rotary has been a very, very good friend to all of us. And so most of you know that just a few miles away from this beautiful area that we call home are some of the most vulnerable children and women that we'll ever come across. We provide educational opportunities for adult women so they get their GED, learn English, gain computer skills, and get a job. We watch their children while they're in the classes, and the Rotary has been most involved with our children's programs. So we have our after-school program for children ages 6 through 12, a teen boys and teen girls program, and they are separate programs, we rarely let them mix, and a beautiful summer camp that spends 3 days a week, as I mentioned before, at the Wyckoff YMCA. This donation in particular, we'd like to use to support our teen boys and girls program, and that program is geared at getting some of our kids into private high schools to get them out of Patterson and provide educational opportunities so they can explore career options they would otherwise not be exposed to, and to create a college-going culture in Patterson. So thank you very much.
Rebuilding Together, North Jersey, Ronnie Little.
Good morning, and thank you for inviting Rebuilding Together, North Jersey here for this honor. What we do in our organization is we provide free to the homeowner home repairs, home improvements for low-income homeowners in Bergen and Passaic counties. So what this means is that disabled veterans and seniors who are no longer able to care for their homes and risk losing their homes, we step in and we give them what they need, whether or not that be a ramp, smoke detectors, CO2 detectors, so that they can feel safe in their home. We help them with asthma problems, we help them with roofing, plumbing, masonry, electrical. And we do this work through the generosity of hundreds of skilled volunteers and hundreds of unskilled volunteers who come out every year and give us a bit of their time and their treasure to help us in this great work. So I'd like to thank the Rotary Club, and that $500 is the difference between someone feeling trapped in their own home and someone having a ramp so they can get in and out safely. Thank you.
Andrea Stott, Relief Bus.
Hi, good morning. Thanks for having us. Thank you so much to the Rotary Club. The New York City Relief Bus has been around for 27 years, and we provide services to the needy and homeless. We go out to the neediest, poorest zip codes in New Jersey, including Patterson and Newark, as well as the South Bronx, Harlem, and Chelsea. We're a mobile soup kitchen, and our base is in Elizabeth. We go there, we make soup in the morning, lemonade, hot chocolate. We load up the buses, and we drive to our locations for the day. Our friends on the street literally are waiting for us. They're holding a spot for us in Harlem, where there is no parking. But because they are desperate for food, fresh bread, friendship that we provide, because they count on us, they know that we are there several times a week. We understand their life, we're listening to them. We also have connections with other resources in New Jersey and New York that can connect them with shelter, job training, detox if necessary. There are times that we literally will take someone from the street to a detox center, that we have those resources available to help them in those areas. And we do, we serve about 12,000 people on the streets monthly. And we have very small staff, so we don't do that with our staff, but we mobilize around 7,000 volunteers annually that help us do everything. So we could not do it without our volunteers. And once people come, they always come back because it's life-altering. I started out as a volunteer, now I'm on staff. So it's life-altering to everybody to be able to see that we actually make a difference every day, just like your words are, every minute of every day, feed someone, house someone, perform surgery, comfort someone. That's exactly in line with our values, what we do. And that's what we're here to do. We have three buses. One is in a little bad condition right now. So that $500 may go towards the generator, which would help, because when you're serving soup on the streets of New York and it's 95 or 100 degrees, air conditioning is critical. So we thank you for your donation. We really appreciate it.
Pastor John Ustite, Servant's Heart.
It's great to be able to speak here and to be able to be back here. So I get the privilege of running Servant's Heart, which pretty much does similar, put construction guys out into the community. We primarily love, empower, train, and serve. So I work with a lot of local builders. I happen to have been in five locations most of my life, so I have lots of skills in construction as well. We tackle all sorts of fun projects, mostly in Patterson, but we also do a lot of stuff out in the suburbs, helping different people that might have needs that come along our way. So thank you for supporting us. Unfortunately, this is gonna have to go this week to a gun, one of our nail guns that got swiped off our truck this week in Patterson. So it'll probably help us afford a new nail gun for the guy that goes out of our truck. That's the nature of what we do. We're in lots of crazy places. So we appreciate your gift and continue to support us. Thank you.
Matthew Talent from Shelter Box USA.
Good morning. Thank you. Shelterbox USA is an organization that started, actually Shelterbox, not Shelterbox USA, started in the year 2000 by a single Rotarian, Tom Henderson, in Cornwall, England. Shelterbox is an international disaster relief organization that provides temporary shelter. In the 17 years we've been in existence, we have supplied approximately 225,000 shelter boxes in 290 disasters in 98 countries. About 3 million people have been aided as a result of that. We are affiliated with Rotary International as a project partner, and we utilize Rotarians on the ground in the affected countries to help us get the goods into the right hands. Thank you.
From Solid Foundation Skate Park.
Good morning. At Solid Foundation, we are celebrating 15 years this year, and I'm pretty sure Midland Park Rotary, Midland Park Bike Hop Rotary Club has been a huge supporter for a majority of that time, so thank you so much. In a nutshell, what we do is we empower young men to do something awesome. And is what that looks like is quite simply connecting young guys with mentors through skateboarding, through art, and through giving back. This gift will be used for one of our service projects. Tomorrow, I'm taking 18 guys, including myself, so 17 guys, to California on a service trip. We're going out to Sequoia National Park, and we'll be doing some work with a good friend of mine at a camp called Hume Lake. So this gift will help us get one of our guys out there, pretty much their whole flight. Really excited about our work in Patterson. There's a lot of skateboarders in Patterson now, and I'd love to come back sometime and share more about some of the skateboarding events we've done in Patterson. Half of our team going to California with me is a bunch of Patterson skateboarders. So thank you for your support, and I'd love to come back and share how it went.
Ellen Forstrom, Touch the World Ministries.
I want to thank you for having me here. From Touch the World Ministries, and one of our part of our organization is the James R. Hanley School in Juarez, Mexico. And we will be starting a new junior high. The foundation will be started to be put in this summer, and this check will be going towards part of that building cost, which is a lot. So thank you so much.
Tracy Arnell from Villa Marie Claire.
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm Tracy Arnauer. I am a supervisor and a hospice liaison at Villa Marie Claire. My apologies, I didn't realize I was going to be speaking this morning, but I'm honored to be here. I did speak once during the year about Villa Marie Claire, which is a not-for-profit hospice in Saddle River, New Jersey. And it's a very important community service that we provide when families are dealing with a loved one who's terminally ill. And I encourage people to look us up online, Villa Marie Claire. We are not-for-profit, as I mentioned. And it's very important to help families understand that futile medical treatments that prolong suffering, that's not how end of life should be. And I'm a social worker, and I feel very, very strong about empowering families to advocate for themselves, speak to their doctors, and understand that quality end of life care is an option. Even for young families, they don't have to die in hospitals. They can be at home with their families, or if they need to come inpatient, they can come to Villa Marie Claire, where we provide 24-hour nursing care and 24-hour aides for personal care. We're on a 26-acre estate in beautiful Saddle River, and families can be outside. And we have a swimming pool, we have a barbecue. We really try to make it a home away from home. And we are also proud to provide charity care to those families who do need the inpatient care and are not able to afford it. Sometimes insurance will cover this care, and sometimes it doesn't. Either way, we do try to meet families wherever they're at, and if they need to come to the villa, we open our doors. So this check is so meaningful and so appreciated. The care we provide to families facing end of life every day. We get a lot of donations, and we can't thank you enough. So thank you for having me.
Tracy DeMarco with Bergen Mental Health.
Well, I am not Tracy, but I am from West Bergen Mental Health. My name is Barbara Crusco, and I'm the Chief Development Officer at West Bergen Mental Health Care. I'm truly honored to be here today to accept this contribution, and we sincerely appreciate your support of our mission. We are a community mental health agency that offers individual, family, and group counseling, as well as residential and school-based services throughout northern New Jersey and beyond. And not only does this contribution help West Bergen financially, but it's truly significant because it's only with the support of friends like you that we can continue to break down the stigma of mental health and mental illness and, you know, chip away at that stigma and continue the work to change the lives of those in our community who need our help the most. So I thank you so much for that, and thank you for your support today.
We have Haley Rooney from White Hook Volunteer Ambulance Corps.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having us. I'm so overwhelmed on such great charities. I'm from the White Hook Ambulance Corps. Last year, we answered over 1,300 calls in White Hook. We also cover Midland Park, Franklin Lakes, Mahwah, Allendale, Waldwick, Hawthorne, North Haldon. And we do mutual aid amongst everything. Midland Park helps us out. This check is going to go toward, we're going to need a new rig. So everything that we have now, we're saving up for a new rig, so we greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Rock and Company from White Hook Volunteer Fire Department.
Good morning. Tim Rock, Chief of the White Hook Fire Department. We are in our 110th year of service. We have 130 plus volunteers that answered somewhere in the area of 600 calls for service last year. And this check will go towards training and equipment. So thank you very much.
And we have White Hook YMCA, Billy's Buddies.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Lee Parker. I'm here with Patty Carson, who is the membership director of the Y. I have both the honor and privilege of doing double duty today. I'm a proud member of this Rotary Club. I've been so for quite a long time. And I'm also a board member of the Y, and I'm privileged to be able to be a giver and a taker today. So, but just a little bit about Billy's Buddies. Billy's Buddies is a specific program that was started 13 years ago, named after Billy Horahan. He's 13 this year. And he was born with Downs. And his parents and his grandmother wanted to do something important in the community to have outreach and create awareness. And it's scary when you have a child that's, you know, born with special needs. You're not really sure where to go, where to turn. And so that was the impetus behind the program. And those folks were, they approached the Y. The Y helped them organize Billy's Buddies 13 years ago and have taken it in-house. And what this program does is it helps certainly the children with Downs, but more importantly, their siblings, their families, their parents. Gives them a place to go to meet with each other, just really better understand what to expect. And it's been a thriving organization for a long time. This particular donation of $1,000 is for a golf outing that we're running next month, July 13th. And that's part of a bunch of different fundraisers we do for Billy's Buddies. But Billy's Buddies, as I said, is part of a larger special needs commitment that the Y has in the community. We really try and help families from the moment their child is born and up until 21 plus. We have everything in between, and we are committed to doing more and more as we can in the future. So this $1,000 does go a long way. I thank you very much.
So this is, I'm going to, you know, obviously we need, there's 30 of us gathered here every Thursday morning, and we need more members. So I was going to ask few moments, speaking from the members and what our experience is like and his experience, his personal experience. Obviously, it means different things to all of us, but we do need people to help us. We obviously leverage to a lot of people, so if you're thinking about being inspired to join us, I'm sure Russ will give you plenty of reasons of why you should do that.
Well, thank you, Peter. It's really a pleasure and an honor for me to have the opportunity to speak with you this morning. 6 years ago, I decided to leave Wall Street and start my own financial service entity here in Midland Park. And similar to the gentleman in the back who mentioned that his wife has just retired, which means he's going to be out of the house a lot, the fact that I'm working from home inspired my wife to collude with Emmy to try to get me out of the house. And I'm so very grateful that they did that, because I did not know what the Rotary organization was, what it stood for, the quality of the people, until I had the opportunity to show up here on a Thursday morning in July of 2011. And it's really been life-altering. You know, I'm humbled to be in the presence of each of you today, because what you do on a day-to-day basis is just so incredible. You touch somebody in so many meaningful ways. And so we're honored to share some of our resources with you. But before I keep going, I'd like each of the members of the Wyckoff Midland Park Rotary to stand to be recognized, because as Peter said, this is a collection of individuals who aren't vast in numbers. We have fewer than 30 members, but what we've been able to accomplish, I think, is pretty extraordinary. So if you would each stand up just so that people might know. And it's just fun. And Rotary, in general, is this massive organization. You know, it's the world's largest service organization at roughly 1.2 million people in more than 200 countries, all trying to accomplish the same objective. Now, in the last couple of years, we've decided to really undertake a greater focus on youth services. So that's become our mission. And what does that mean for us? Well, really, what it means is the support of people like Zoe. Zoe went to Midland Park High School, so she would have had the opportunity to be in the Indirect Club, similar to those young adults who are in Ramapo High School. And we support the Indirect Club. In Midland Park, there are more than 80 students who are involved in the service organization. And hopefully, it's a stepping stone to wanting to get more involved. And so when Zoe reached out to us the other day, I was thrilled, because you know, we're a collection of mature individuals, and we could use some younger, more energetic individuals with a different perspective to come and support our efforts. So it's wonderful that Zoe, who was a scholarship recipient a couple of years ago from us, benefited from our involvement, and now she's looking to give back, which is just extraordinary. That's exactly what we're hoping for, because you are our future, and we need more people like you to roll up your sleeves and want to get involved. So I thank you again for being here today. I've been inspired by each of you, and it keeps me wanting to do more and more to reach into our communities to help wherever we possibly can. And again, I would encourage you to get involved. You know, there are no secret handshakes. There is no special code that you have to know. You know, we don't charge people at the door to come and visit. We do encourage you to come and just get to know us, and hopefully want to do more with us, even if you don't want to join us on a formal basis. Just getting involved in volunteering for our triathlon. And Mr. Madigan mentioned the 50-50, you know, participating by purchasing a ticket. Our beef steaks in October, it's a great event. We have about 325 of our closest friends coming and just gorging themselves on the steak and french fries and onion rings and a whole bunch of other things. And so it's fundraisers for us so that we can turn around and do something like this for you. It's our way of thanking you for what you do on a day-to-day basis, and we couldn't do that if we didn't get the involvement of our community supporting our efforts. And so again, I thank you for what you do. I thank each and every one of the Rotarians for making my life more special. And I would hope that one or more of you would want to become a bigger part of our organization. So hopefully we'll see you. Cindy is going to be our new president. Peter has done an incredible job. Whoever's left, we'll go on the steps and crush in and get to know each other. And thank you for coming.